This is ABC 7 News at 11.
You know, there are nearly 600 people on California's death row, but they're not as isolated from the rest of the world as you might think.
Nearly one-fifth of them are on the World Wide Web, even though none of them have access to the Internet. ABC 7's Cameron Harper has a story in the special report.
They are some of the worst criminals in California history, convicted of killing men, women, and children. Sentenced to die at San Quentin, supposedly removed from society, sealed off from the world.
At the time that they are sentenced behind the walls of San Quentin death row, that's the end of their voice. They're not to be out here in this world anymore. That's why the judge sentenced them there.
Janice Keeson's daughter, Darlene Paris, had grown up and was preparing to set out on her own. But she never got the chance. She was murdered during a home invasion in Salida near Manteca. Four people were killed, 23-year-old Darlene Paris, as she reached for a rear door. Three of the men involved were sentenced to die. It was the last time Janice Keeson ever wanted to hear about them. But that was before the internet explosion.
Darlene Paris didn't grow up with a computer. Her family didn't even own one. In fact, in 1990, when this murder happened, the internet wasn't much of a factor in many of our lives. But today, her killers are just a mouse click away.
Darlene's killers reached out into cyberspace. Tipped off by a friend, Janice logged on and found that two of her daughter's killers, James Beck and Gerald Cruz, were looking for pen pals.
I broke down and I just started crying and I became very angry and very hostile. And I thought, my God, how can they do this? They had silenced Darlene forever, and yet they were still being heard.
After she protested, their names were removed from the site. But her battle has not ended. She says hundreds of others on death row are still online.
So we searched the internet to see how many websites we could find for death row inmates. The result? Nearly one in five murderers sentenced to die in California is reaching out to touch someone online.
It is a virtual who's who on death row, with killers like Ramon Salcido and Richard Allen Davis online. Under California law, none of these inmates is actually allowed direct access to the internet, but someone on the outside can do it for them.
Now, since we began in May of 1998, we've been creating web pages for individuals who are sentenced to death.
The Canadian Coalition Against the Death Penalty lists hundreds of death row inmates from around the country. They offer them a place to post poetry, comments, and artwork.
If the United States is going to remain as one of the few countries left in the Western Hemisphere that still executes its own citizens, then obviously the American public and the rest of the world public have the right to know who the United States government has deemed worthy of death.
But not all death row inmates who are on the web are limiting themselves to anti-death penalty sites. Some have websites dedicated just to them. Ironically, one of the condemned men who's reaching out is writing from the very place where he committed his crime. Jarvis J. Masters, a career criminal, was sentenced to die for planning the murder of a San Quentin guard in 1985. Less than a year ago, Hal Birchfield's widow discovered that Masters was online.
And I was just aghast. I was so mad. I was so angry. I was in such turmoil over it. I physically got ill for about 2 weeks.
Masters wrote a book about his life behind bars, and it is sold through the website to raise money for his legal fees.
Once he was convicted and put on death row, he lost that right to those privileges. Those privileges to have a website, those privileges to sell a book.
Those who run Jarvis Masters' website say they sympathize with Barbara Birchfield, but they believe Jarvis Masters was wrongly convicted. The website says Masters is reformed and has taken vows of nonviolence.
You don't get to death row by being a peaceful, nurturing, loving human being.
We tried to speak with someone from the website on camera, but they declined, saying it's not going to be the kind of exposure we want. These groups believe the web is an important tool, helping educate the public about the incarcerated and argue against the death penalty.
If these individuals were sent to life in prison, as they would be in most other free countries of the world, there'd be no need for our outreach.
The victims of violence, though, see it much differently. They are angry that the inmates sentenced to death are still very much alive on the World Wide Web.
So what do you want done about these websites where the prisoners can ask for pen pals?
I want it stopped. I want it stopped now.
Cameron Harper, ABC 7 News.
Now, two states have stopped it. Washington and Arizona both have passed laws that prevent inmates from establishing websites.
All right.